Welcome back to the Traxion channel. My name is Rich. I'm joined by John, and I'm joined by John for a very important reason today, and that's because finally, after all this time, I am finally going to sit him down and make him play Split Second, my prop favorite racing game of all time. You might have seen here on the Traxion channel last year, I did a video all about it. You can click or tap up here or click the link in the description below, or watch till the end and I'll stick it on the end card thing. You can go watch my video gushing about this game, and we have yet to do a live play of it, and John is yet to play the game at all.
Yeah, my only experience of Split Second is through Rich's video, and this is one of the first things when you started work for Traxion. You were like, I need to make a Split Second video, needs to be done, and all I've done is watch the video. I've kept myself out of it, so for me, this is, I'm going in blind. Like, and I've been looking forward to this for a long time, because we've been discussing this for a while now.
We have indeed. It's been a long time coming, and there is a reason why we're finally getting around to doing this today, but we'll tell you about that a bit later. So you're going in completely fresh, no cars unlocked, no nothing. There's a few achievements, because I had to do some testing to make sure all worked, but otherwise you are going in completely blind. And the best thing to start with, as well as a good sync point for me in the edit, I'm gonna make you watch the intro, which you kind of saw from watching the retrospective video I did, and I missed this Xbox 360 splash so much.
It's very nice. I've seen bits of this for sure. You can even see the pixels.
It's capturing in 4K, but the game is very much not running in 4K. I'll tell you that much. And this was the thing that threw so many people off. It's a Disney game.
Yeah,
Disney published this.
It's bizarre, because it doesn't seem like a Disney game.
No, not at all. R.I.P. Rest in peace, BlackRock. Please come back and make Split Second 2.
This is... Okay, so yeah, we are constructing a film set here, aren't we?
Yes.
Half expecting Lazy Generation to start playing. This is very like Burnout 3.
Well, it's from that era. This was Burnout 3, Split Second, Blur. These games from 2010 that people just absolutely adored. Like, this age of arcade racing has never really come back. We were talking about this in the office yesterday. Like, all these arcade races that people remember so fondly, they're all from at least like 10 years ago. Because as much as there are fantastic arcade races out there now, I'd say most recently things like Hot Wheels Unleashed comes to mind, but none of them have that same kind of effect on people like games like this do.
This is all very, very cool.
All big, bombastic, stupid, but it took itself very seriously, which is something I really appreciate about this. John needs to do the tutorial.
I've done well on the written test, but now it's time to prove your skill on the track.
And the thing is, like, for a game from 2010, I know that it's obviously running, like, blown up to 4K on a massive TV that we're playing on at the moment. And I know that you can see a lot of the anti-aliasing, you can see it, but like, for the time, this was a genuinely stunning game. And like, I think it still holds up really well today.
Yeah, 100%. This looks cool.
Like, when I did the video on the Traxion channel, I actually captured that on PC. So I played the game at 4K, and everything looked really, really crispy. Obviously, on a console, it's running at like, it's probably about 720p, to be honest, not even 1080p, but still, like, visually, I think it is one of the best looking games on the 360.
It's 100%. Very cool. You've definitely got that era of color as well. That kind of slightly off.
It's all very gray.
We have a specific term for it that we're probably not going to say on this video, but yeah.
It's the Gears of War era. That's Gears of War and COD 4. That was what like indiced this color palette.
It's handling wise so far, it feels like it's clearly not it's not a simulation. It feels nice and intuitive though, like. And the drifting starts very naturally as well. I mean, I can't keep it in a straight line.
The thing is, once you get your head around one of the cars, because the thing about this game is all the cars do feel different to drive. It's not a cosmetic thing. And they made loads of cars in this game. They're all fictional as well. Nothing licensed, nothing real. As much as you can probably look at a car and go, oh, this looks like that. Like, kind of like how Grand Theft Auto do. Like, oh, this is definitely not an Audi, but it very much looks like an Audi. All the cars feel very different to drive.
Yeah.
And they all have their own different stats in the racing and stuff like that. So, you know, picking your favorite car is a genuine, like, it's a bit of a trial by fire, like, trying to choose what your favorite car is. Like, I have my favorite car in this game, which won't be unlocked, unfortunately. You see, I love the design.
A bear drift.
I love the chevron design of these cars, and I'm really annoyed you can't play as them in the game.
That makes sense. You need to get more power. Okay, that was successful. Move on to the next
stage. When you start nailing drifts like that, it is like, wow,
it's satisfying.
It's really satisfying. When you get that car that you know is like you're resonating with it so well, you will just stick to that car going forwards.
That makes sense, yeah. I'm still trying to get the hang of when to start the drifting and how to balance it and stuff like that. But it feels good, it feels good. It's almost like the Yokohama docks and the grid games as well, this kind of film set. I didn't actually realise, so the TV show or film this is obviously based on, as he climbs on top of me, is actually called Split Second.
Yes.
Is where the game title
comes
from.
So you're technically, you are a contestant in the game show Split Second. That's what the context of the game is.
Okay, B when I see this one, okay. So you've got to look for the icons as well.
So they'll appear above the cars that you can
do. Okay. Yeah. That makes a lot of sense. I'm waiting for one to appear, essentially. Turning it too early. Right, there we go. Oh, I like the slow-mo. Yeah. Oh, this is very cool. I love that you have control of the explosives way up ahead of you. Like, that's... Yeah, it's epic. And it is quite clear as well with the logos as well and the colour.
Absolutely. So using, perfect timing there.
There we go.
With those helicopters, I always leave, when the thing appears, you give it a second, and then you drop it, and you can literally land the barrel right on top of somebody.
So it's timing as well. It's not just press as soon as you see the
Well,
thing.
You can do, because it will have an area of effect. It will affect them. But for something like the helicopters that hover above the track, I usually give it, like, hesitate a little bit, and then drop it. Obviously, if you leave it too long, the symbol will disappear, and you can't use it.
Yeah.
I'm trying not to give you too many tips, because, like, I want you to... Like, these, the AI cars like this, they all have, like, no health, so...
Well,
you sort of
instantly.
Cough on it and it'll explode, so it's okay.
Good news. You made the show.
I made the show?
You did it.
What a surprise.
Imagine that. You finished the tutorial and the guy's like, nah, mate, you're not good enough.
You're not good enough. Sell the game.
The Xbox just ejects the disc for you.
Rig to blow. New on air. This episode. Okay, so this is episode one. And so you were telling me how this works.
Yeah.
So it's you've got a number of challenges or scenarios within each episode, right?
Yep. And then there's 12 episodes in the season, and the season of the show is the main campaign of the game.
Yeah, cool.
This is Split Second. If you like insanely fast cars and explosive action, you've come to the right place. Over the next 12 exciting episodes, contestants from around the world will battle it out on the track with the aim of qualifying for the chance to race the Split Second Elite. This band of highly trained drivers are all that stand between the contestants going home and progression
classic
to the next round.
Logos and team names.
Yes.
The hammer.
As the contestants choose which events they want to enter, aiming to earn enough credits to qualify to the Elite Championship race, bridges will fall, buildings reduced to clouds of dust, and no corner can be considered safe. Drivers, choose your events carefully, and remember to buckle up. It's about to get explosive out there.
Yeah. Testosterone flowing through my veins.
Good. That's what I like to hear. So now you can pick which of these to do.
Yeah.
So you unlock credits for completing them, and where you place X number of credits, you get cars, and then you can unlock the bonus event and then the elite race at the end, as you can see, in 150 credits. So.
Cool. Let's start with Airport Terminal. That seems like a very sensible place to start in first race. So you basically just have to win the races, right? But you can win either by overtaking or by building up your power bar and blowing
You get
them
to
up.
The front by any means necessary.
It's kind of like Burnout in a sense, where you'd crash your rivals off the course or just beat them by being good.
Pretty much.
But being good's not as fun. Not as easy.
Blowing stuff up is
blowing
much
stuff
more
up's
fun.
A bit. Yeah, exactly. Let's do it. What's
going to
happen?
Entire
oh
terminal.
My god! Ooh, I can't even see where we're going. Apparently, I'm in the lead. Okay, I like that very much. So the amazing thing as well is like, it almost seemed like it was perfectly timed there with passing the airport when I got that big boost. But it could have been anywhere, right? And you could have had any situation happen.
Yep.
That's very cool.
One thing they didn't tell you in the tutorial is when you fill up your bar all the way to the top, you can obviously do level 2 power plays, or you can change the route of the track as well.
Oh, right, okay.
By doing even bigger explosions.
Oh, switch routes. Let's try that then, yeah. Why not? Oh my god. Oh wow. Okay. Amazing. I love that happens. Like, it doesn't feel like it's pre-scripted or anything. It just feels like the game will do anything that you ask it to.
Yep.
Which I love that about a game, where it makes it feel like you're in full control. Let's get him. If I do that to someone too close to me, it can take me out as well,
right? You can take yourself out as well, yep.
Yeah. Music feels like I'm watching Alex Rider Stormbreaker or something.
Oh, man. Robbie Coltrane playing the Prime Minister. May he rest in peace. It's
incredible.
Like everyone's...
Stephen Fry is the...
Like,
the
genuinely.
What do you call him?
Such a...
The scientist. Like the guy who comes up with all the tools.
He's Q, isn't he, basically?
That's not a good name for it.
When obviously, the announcement of Robbie Coltrane passing away came about, I'm there thinking, yeah, obviously Ow. Hagrid. And then I'm just there like, yeah, but Stormbreaker.
Yeah. I mean, it was a terrible film, but it was also kind of amazing.
Stormbreaker. Yeah. Like, look at the cast of it. And you think, oh my... How did they get away with, like, making such an unfortunate film? Oh, you just got nuked.
Am I out?
No, you respawn.
Okay, that's fine.
like such an amazing film with an amazing cast. Like you've got Andy Serkis is in it, Bill Nye's in it. Like, crikey. Highly recommend this one.
Right. I almost forgot to press it. Oh God, which way are we going now then? Oh my. Oh. Instant replay, let's have that. What is their budget, Rich?
It's quite
Split
big.
Split second have a very...
It's quite big, yeah.
It must be funny, when you've played this game obviously a lot, and yeah. watching someone who's never played it, it must be so frustrating watching the lack of like good opportunities taken.
For so, like, obviously I've introduced loads of people to Split Second at uni. This was like the one game I showed everyone. And watching people play it, I love it. Because I don't have that. It's not like when you're watching somebody play Portal and they're just struggling to see something that's so blatantly obvious. With this, I'm just like, nah, you do you. You yeah. blow stuff up and have a good time. That was quite an easy win for you, I think.
Yeah, it was all right, actually. It was okay. It held my hand. I'm happy for that to happen at this stage. Just gonna have a quick look here. It's almost like a Dodge Charger or Challenger even type thing. Even a Camaro a little bit. It's a bit of everything, really.
Yeah.
And then this one's almost like, it looks like a kind of modern day. Again, they're predicting the future. This looks more like a current gen Sprint Cup car than anything that was around back then.
Yeah. So,
yeah, very ahead of the times. What are we going to do? Let's try something different. Let's go for this one then. Big is slow, but it's very strong.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, we're underway.
So this is only two laps. It's a slightly longer track.
Okay. So there's no boost button or anything I can use. So yeah, so you build up your power-ups simply to crash into other people, change routes.
And that's what I like about it is it's simplicity.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You're just driving around a track, you drift around, you blow stuff up.
Oh, I missed them all.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I see how it works. I'm still getting used to how it all goes together, but yeah, you want to look for objects and try and time it where you think that they're going to be hit.
There are repetitive objects and things like that bus that got thrown into the track. You have those on the airport terminal. You've got obviously the helicopters above. Things like the digger scoop, and there's like wrecking balls on some of the tracks and stuff like that. So,
oh yeah, yay, we got one.
You got two.
Oh, ooh. Almost got myself. Yeah, this thing does not handle as well or go as fast as the previous car. I can feel it.
But
it
when you get hit by a shockwave like that, because it all kind of goes a bit warmer, the actual visuals.
Yeah.
Like you don't get affected by that shockwave as much as say the smaller cars do.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, it's the strength coming in. That makes a lot of sense. It's simple, isn't it? And that's what so many games nowadays lack. At times, that simplicity of something that's fun and it works. It doesn't need to. Oh, that was terrible. Fair play, Miles. Congratulations. How do you feel? Hope you like that. Destroying a newbie. But yeah, I do feel like modern games can sometimes try so hard to be complex and as advanced as possible that they kind of forget to just look after the basics.
Quad wreck there, John. That one really does get the AI, though, and it just swaps the sides of where the open line is.
Oh, my. Right, I'm staying left. So the prompt comes up as they're coming up to an action zone.
So they're within the blast radius of it. So sometimes nuking it straight away is a good idea. Sometimes you might, when you have more of an understanding as to what it is you'll be doing at that point on the track, it might be worth leaving it. How did they avoid that? My goodness.
Oh my God. It's just, this thing is just so cumbersome. Can't wait to get rid of it. I think if I finish P2, I think that's probably okay for now. We'll just make the progress is what we need, not perfection. Is the music set to individual circuits?
Nope. Or music is random. So, I think the elite races at the end have a specific soundtrack. Whereas, anything else, it will pick a random bit of music, and then all the effects on the track will dynamically affect the music as well.
I think I've got one or two corners left.
You've got one corner left. You could potentially take him on the inside. Oh, he's giving you a little bump draft.
Block
him.
No.
Ooh. Amazing.
I'm sorry I was ever doubted you, car.
But you're also going back in the garage and not coming out again.
Exactly. Bron GP of Split Second.
Oh.
Look at that. That's very nice. Another Cobretti. That's the Iridium. Okay.
So elimination events, which are what they say on the tin. 60 seconds from the green flag, person at the back gets nuked. 30 seconds after that, next one, and so on and so forth. So,
looking at this, the new car is not that quick anyway. So what I'm thinking.
If you go back to your, if you go back to that was even slower.
Oh yeah, so the acceleration's big, right? So the top speed's about. That is terrible. Okay, so I was moaning about my car. It's not even that bad. Let's try the new one then. Let's give it a go. I'm guessing you get a bit of a preview of some of the future cars based on the rivals as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Like a Viper lookalike ahead.
So you're currently in last place. You need to get ahead.
This thing's got slightly Spyker C6 vibes about it. That's a very niche reference. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's so much better. Yeah. Almost blew up myself there, but I got away with it. See, now this car is going to make me... I shouldn't speak in advance. This car is possibly going to make me look like a better driver. It's not me. It's fully this car. It's so easy to drift.
Oh, the only downside of the cabs going across is they are very slow to cross the entire track.
Yeah. So how old would you have been then when you played this game?
I would have been 15.
15.
When I first played this game.
Oh, ideal.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because this thing, sometimes the thing that gets me with old games is part of me is like, is it an age thing in terms of I enjoyed it because I was a certain age? Or is it just because the games themselves have changed so much? So like, you know, would an adult have enjoyed this long ago? I'm sure they would have, but it's not always, like sometimes it's about the age you were when you play a game and sometimes it's about the age and style of a game and it's sometimes hard to work out, you know, why you thought a game was so good. Was it because I was really young or was it because it was just really good?
Yeah. Well, it's like, this is one of those games, the reason why I rant and rave about it so much is because of the fact that it's aged so well.
Yeah. I mean, like, this looks amazing now. Like, I'm
for a game in 2010,
yeah.
Like, it looks incredible.
I mean, we're playing in what is essentially, like, very stretched, what, 720?
Pretty much. And, on, like, a 70-inch TV, yeah, capturing
the biggest
4K.
TV ever.
So it's, like, it's definitely not being put into its best sort of...
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, I hit the bricks there at the right time.
Yeah, yeah. But it's not in the best sort of situation, yeah, scenario, but... Oh,
thank you very much.
Somebody took the lead out for you.
Yeah. But yeah, okay, you're down to even then, it looks really, really good.
Like, yeah.
And you don't notice the 30 FPS either.
Well, exactly. That's what I mean. I'm a massive stickler for frame rates. I mean, I play on PC predominantly. So a friend of mine put up on Twitter the other day a poll, like, what would you rather do? Like, graphics at 30 or performance at 60? And it's like, I don't see why that's a question.
Yeah.
It should be 60. Oh, God, you're getting...
Oh, there's only three of
you. This is not good. There's only three of you.
It's fine. I'm hanging on to my power-ups.
It's a 1v1.
Okay.
You might get you on the inside.
That's
here.
Fine,
yes,
that's
you will.
Fine. We'll...
You got 13 seconds.
This was
bit
a mistake.
Early!
Oh, I took myself out. Oh,
no! Keep going. I think you might be too far ahead.
Yeah, yeah.
That I mean, was... P2, it's not bad.
I mean, it's a learning process. That's all I can say. I took myself out with my power-up. But that is the kind of thing that you learn to...
Oh!
You learn to avoid. Hang on a minute.
Wait, did he get taken out as well? Were you ahead of him at that point?
Was I him? Was he me?
We'll have to check that in the recording of the game capture, because maybe you did take him out as well. It looked, but the positioning of when you took yourself out, it looked like he was almost directly behind you, which would have meant he would have got taken out as well.
I mean, I'd given up at that point.
But it said danger. Unless he managed to crash himself or something. Or you were, because I saw you were spamming A, weren't you?
Maybe it was just a general, you know, it's dangerous. Be wary. Either way,
things are exploding. 100%
record.
And you qualify for the bonus event as well.
Right. So we've got three more events left: Downtown Central Elimination, Airport Terminal Detonator, and the Elite Race. So let's just keep rolling through.
Absolutely.
Another elimination race. I did quite enjoy my Cabretti Iridium. I'm going to stick with that. I don't know at this point if it's going to get a bit tiresome, the same events happening on different tracks, but right now I have no idea what's going to happen, and that is exciting.
Well, when you get further through the episodes, there are more events as well.
Yeah.
So it's not just races, there's not just Eliminator, there's not just Time Trial. There's a particular one where you're doing laps around, not a normal track, it's a specifically made track, and you've got all these trucks dropping barrels out the back of the truck, and you have to dodge them.
Nice.
And see how long you can last to score points. There's airstrike, which is literally like setting laps around the track, and there's a helicopter above you throwing missiles down.
Yeah.
Dodge it and see how long you can survive for. And then there's air revenge, which is the same kind of thing with the helicopter striking down, except when you build up power, you can basically deflect rockets back at the helicopter and try and take it out as quickly as you can.
Okay.
So there's a bunch of different things. And I think there was actually a DLC as well for a second. That gave you an extra track, and it did give you an extra game mode, and I can't actually remember what it is, which is bad for me because I actually only picked up the DLC a couple of years ago.
All right.
Interestingly,
that's cool.
Booted
another
my 360,
reason to flip it up.
Tried to get into my old Xbox Live account and bought the DLC for Split Second, which I did for some reason I'd never bought. Maybe it's because it was back in the days of buying Microsoft points. Remember that?
Yeah. I never had an Xbox.
So oh no,
I
you, did you were PlayStation, weren't you?
PC. I did PC stuff, but yeah, it was PlayStation for me.
Buying map packs and Call of Duty for 1,200 Microsoft.
Oh yeah,
goes to game, gets a prepaid
us,
card. God,
yeah.
Those were the days.
Oh,
but, I mean,
yeah.
They weren't. I hated having to buy an extra currency. It was a pain. That's a good one. That's a really good one to get some plays back.
If you're in a crazy lobby with lots of crash and you want a good acceleration.
Oh no! Oh, that takes out one half of the track as well. So when you get
that, and that's it.
Oh no, that was Oh dear. You've unlocked the elite race, so
we
that's
take the rough
thing.
With the smooth.
Exactly. That's what we you do. Can't win everything.
First of all, we've got airport terminal detonator.
So this is setting a lap time with all the power plates just going off around you.
Okay, I like that.
So, and it will put you in a specific car as well.
Very nice. The Nissan GTR, love it.
Yeah, I was going to say it's the Hanzo cars are very much, as the name might suggest, are very Japanese.
That makes a lot of sense.
So you can see the inspiration behind the cars, but there is that element of they've just gone and designed a bunch of their own cars, which I really like.
Do you know what though? They kind of look more like current cars than the cars at the time did. Like it's almost like in some ways these were inspired by the cars, but they also inspired cars that came after it.
Maybe they looked at like concept cars,
yeah, definitely,
rather than current like cars at the time.
Tell me that's not a like GT86/Supra.
Yeah,
nowadays.
It fully is, isn't it?
Well done, Split Second, predicting the future, setting the trends. In the
absolutely.
Future. Okay, so this is the lap time challenge. So yep. Normally this would be in my element. However, on Split Second, nothing is my element yet.
Most of the things will go off ahead of you.
Yeah, so you can see.
So
them
you should be okay, but you might get hit by some shockwaves and bits and pieces like that. So.
I have a question for you. Is it always faster to drift than not to drift, or is that just for building up? Like lap time wise, should I be avoiding drifting?
No, not necessarily.
Okay, I could have. I was about to go through the fuel station there.
These are the ones that are going to get you most. The ones that will actually move out into the track.
Oh dear.
Okay, here comes the plane.
Oh, plane. What plane?
That one.
Oh no! Oh no! I think I remember that from your video.
Yep. I played that clip so many times in the video because I just, yeah, I love it so much.
Epic. The target time is
10 seconds to the line. No, he's done it. He's lost it.
I couldn't decide which side, way to go.
3, 2, 1. Okay, second place. Ah, you'll get second, I think. Or maybe. Oh, we cut it fine. No, you got second. You're good. 132.
Yeah.
So it was 125 for first place, and in last place before you started was Hudson with a 2-minute lap time. So he'd managed to lose 40 seconds by cocking up across the lap. So you're an episode down. What do you think?
I really enjoyed it. I really, really enjoyed it. I think it holds up well. Handling takes a little bit of getting used to, but I think by the end of it there, I was starting to get, especially in a car that drifts well, you do begin to kind of get the hang of it.
Eventually, you will just click with a car.
Yeah, exactly. And I love the fact that you get that little preview of what's coming next, the cinematics, the not knowing what's coming up. I'm sold. I really, really like it. And that's not me just being polite and saying that. I'm genuinely
that's
very
the thing,
impressed.
Like,
and I expect to be impressed.
People, I rave about this game so much,
yeah.
As I've said, but like when I get people to actually play it, like I said, I did this at uni, like everyone who ever came to visit, it was like, oh, I've got a 360, there you go, play Split Second. And they'd all be like, oh my God, this is so good.
Yeah, like what I would say about this, right, is that this game is all about the visuals and the cinematic experience. So would it not be the perfect game to have a new version of, not necessarily Split Second, but something similar that's 4K, that's got all the cinematic stuff, but you can see it beautifully clearly. And you know, this is like the perfect game that could be made nowadays, I think, because graphics have come as far as anything else in games. I'd say the graphics have come further than the development of game modes themselves and things like that.
I feel like I would rather have a remake of this than a sequel.
Yeah. No,
because there was a sequel bait at the end of the thing, but Disney closed BlackRock back in 2011, unfortunately. So the sequel never came. So, but now, like I said, now we've been playing it, and it's like I know that they could add more to it, but I'm also like just remaster it.
Yeah.
But I don't know where the licensing lies, because does it still lie with Disney? Is it with somebody else? Is it with some random bloke's estate somewhere? We don't know.
Do
exactly.
It, random bloke in the estate.
Yeah.
Remake
give
it.
Us the, give remaster us the rights it. And let us do a Split Second remaster.
Darren did tell me to say something like, it's good, but it's not quite as good as Blur, just to annoy you. But I was like, I can't really deliver that in a good way, because I've never played Blur.
Yeah, actually, do you know what? When you were mentioning earlier about simplicity, that's the thing that I think this has over Blur, because I was writing an article, a script about Split Second versus Blur, because I finally went and bought it from CEX and I played Blur. Because everyone at the time in 2010 was like, basically everyone was playing Blur, no one was playing Split Second, and I was there going, no, Split Second is better. And now I've played them, I'm like, yeah, I think the simplicity of Split Second makes it the better game.
Yeah.
Fair. Because with Blur, you've got all these arbitrary icons that are your items and things like that, and it plays fine.
Yeah,
but I don't think it plays as well as this. So, as much as I am very much biased for 12 years of playing this game, Split Second over Blur. And that's kind of the bombshell note that I'm almost going to end on. Because, as I said at the beginning, there's a reason why I've sat John down, I've strapped him to the sofa, not like that, to play Split Second. And we're finally getting around to this video because this is going to be my last video here on Traxion GG on YouTube.
Cry.
I'm moving on to pastures new. I can't even speak. I'm choking up, John. but yeah, genuinely, like, the reason we've come about to finally get this video done is because I am going to be leaving the Traxion team. As of the time of this video going live,
literally,
I will
minute.
Be a free agent. Yeah, literally, the moment this is done, I'm dead to everyone here.
You're already dead to everyone here.
Oh, there's I am moving on to something new, which for those of you who follow me on Twitter will find out eventually. But it's only been, you know, it's been about 2 years here. I was here for the I arrived just after the channel launched back in, because I arrived in March and the channel launched in February last year. And being part of this team, building this channel and seeing how much it's grown. I mean, when I started here, it would have been on not that many subscribers at all.
Oh, like, and maybe 3,000 or 4,000?
Probably not
like
even
that.
I think it was less than that. And then now, like, looking at our readout just on the TV right now, 45,800 as of the time of recording. It's an immense... immense thing to have done, to be part of. You know, I've done a lot of YouTube in my time. I've started channels like nobody's business, and starting from something completely fresh compared to starting a channel underneath a network that already existed that could do all the promotion it wanted to and build a channel up from there. Starting from scratch with you guys at Traxion has been an absolute pleasure and an honor. And I've, you know, the content that you guys have produced and will continue to produce, I will say, has been amazing. And I know that, you know, as much as behind the scenes I was involved in Traxion, not as much as you, as much as Osley, as much as those behind the scenes who you won't see on camera very much that work on the channel. There's a lot of good stuff to come. And I really hope that all of you watching who, be it because you found the channel naturally or you might have come along with me, because I know I did bring a couple of people with me who were like, oh, I do racing as well. Traxion sounds good. I hope you will continue to support the wonderful people who produce the content here and just the channel in general going forwards.
So. Can I just chip in quickly here as well? Just for the folk on watching this video that have seen Rich obviously presenting videos and doing lots of hardware reviews and stuff, what you might not know is Rich is also heavily responsible for working the cameras behind the scenes, setting up the audio. He does most of the thumbnails for the Traxion videos. Plenty of the best looking thumbnails are Rich specials, as we like to call them. So he does so much as well that you don't see on camera. So obviously we are all going to miss you hugely, but we're all delighted that you're going on to something that you're very passionate about, and I'm sure you guys will all find out very soon. But yeah, it's been an absolute pleasure. So
it
thank you very much.
Wonderful.
It's a weird feeling. It's like, I'm delighted, but
I don't really know how to, because as of right now, I'm still got like 2 days left. So I'm kind of like, I don't know how it's going
to... Two days a split second.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Done. Sorted.
I mean, that's fine with me. But there we go. That is it. That is it from me. Here on Traxion GG. As a poet, and I didn't even know it. John, it has been an absolute pleasure to be making this content with you over the last sort of nearly 2 years, and to everyone who I've had the chance to work with here at Traxion, and everyone watching and subscribing and liking and commenting and sharing, etc. Thank you. And I hope you continue to stick around with this lovely lot here at Traxion. And I know I'll be in the comments hurling abuse at John in some way, shape,
or form. We'll get you in some videos in the future as well. We'll make it happen.
I want to see
we'll
a John try split second playthrough series.
But I'm just crying the whole way through.
Absolutely. But that is it from me. Thank you all so much for watching. Keep it pinned. Take care. And I'll see you at some point.